This is NBC 15 News at 6.
Now at 6, a tragic ending in the search for a missing 8-year-old. Joseph Anderson's body has been found. Good evening, I'm John Stofflett.
And I'm Lee Mills. An autopsy is being performed on the 8-year-old Reedsburg boy right now. Joseph Anderson's body was found just after 8 o'clock this morning in the Baraboo River. Joseph was reported missing Wednesday night. He was last seen about 6 hours earlier when he went outside to play.
Only on NBC 15 News, Joey's family went to bed last night hoping he would be found the next day, and he was, but it was obviously not the outcome they were hoping for. NBC 15's Zach Schultz met up with Joey's grandmother today.
When we heard from Bev Hudzinski yesterday, she was making an emotional plea for her grandson to come home.
When the sheriff's department called off the search for Joey Thursday night, Bev Hudzinski continued her own search.
I went up and down all the roads looking for his little red outfit.
Missing since Wednesday afternoon, Bev held out hope that Joey was just lost in the woods.
Because I knew the longer it went on, it was going to be worse. I really just thought maybe he just disappeared, just wanted to run and be a little boy.
Bev barely slept and woke up to bad news.
And then I woke up and my nephew called my sister and told me that they've found something, and it wasn't good. So that's how I found out.
Joey had been found in the Baraboo River, less than a mile from his house.
He loved the water. That was my fear, the water. I did not know that there was a body of water that close to their house. I thought it was just woods, and that was my fear.
Bev says the news was crushing for Joey's biological mother and his older sister, especially since they hadn't seen him recently and were supposed to visit him soon.
But it's going to be really rough from here on in.
She says the one bright spot for the family has been the support of the community.
I just want to say thank you to everyone that didn't even know the family, that didn't know him, but just went out there and gave their time to help find him in the search.
Zach Schultz, NBC 15 News.
Volunteers came out over the past 2 days to help look for Joseph Anderson. Tonight, the family, those volunteers, and the Reedsburg community are mourning his death. NBC 15's Barkley Pollock continues our team coverage with reaction from the community.
3, 4, 5.
Volunteers showed up in bunches to Reedsburg's RACA. After checking in, they packed buses. Their goal? To find Joseph Anderson. And shortly after daybreak, they thought they would.
Everybody's got to be optimistic. Otherwise, what's the point of being here?
Do you still feel optimistic going?
Oh, yeah, definitely. Definitely, especially with the weather conditions.
Most were willing to do anything and stay as long as they were needed.
As long as I have to be.
But that optimism and can-do spirit was quickly crushed. Unconfirmed reports of Joseph's passing surfaced. Shortly after 9 a.m. this morning, the nightmare became a reality.
We located Joey. He was in the river. He has passed away.
This building here in Reedsburg, where volunteers gathered earlier in the day to aid in the search for Joseph, is now empty, and the only sign that they were ever here is on this door, and it says that their help is no longer needed. This afternoon, volunteers who were eager to begin the search this morning returned to their daily routines, still in shock.
It was pretty hard. Everybody on the bus kind of stopped and said a prayer.
I was kind of shocked and I was really sad. You know, I wanted to be able to go out there and help, and we hadn't even made it out there to go and search for him.
Word quickly spread and soon made it to everyone, like this man, a former neighbor of the boy's adoptive parents, back in Reedsburg visiting his family.
Really, really sad because I used to play in the Baraboo River. I grew up right next to him.
In Reedsburg, Barkley Pollock, NBC 15 News.
As you heard, many of the people we spoke to say it was a tragic ending, but hope it at least brings some closure to the family. And stay with us for continuing coverage of this story. We will bring you the latest updates on the death investigation on air and on NBC15.com.